Erev Tov Chavrim, I'm Stephen Ben-Nun. You're watching Israeli News Live, a whirlwind of information this evening. Everything from what appears to be that President Putin of Russia is working on a military alliance across the Middle East there. Also, a nuclear leak, a radioactive nuclear leak that has been detected clear to Romania. Very troubling issues that are going on. And of course, when we deal with the situation of an alliance that may be forming amongst Arabic nations with Russia there. And now, of course, as we see here, President Putin, President Trump speak today for about an hour on the telephone. Neither side is really saying the gist of everything that has come out of this conversation. But clearly, Syria has been on the agenda and Iran has been on the agenda from what we can understand thus far. Russia has let out from the Kremlin that safe zones inside of Syria is one of those issues that were brought up in the conversation, as well as President Putin favors the Iran nuclear deal that was signed with President Barack Obama and that it should stay enforced. Now, we'll have to wait to see how this plays out in the next couple of days, who reveals what's spoken about there. But clearly, what we have been watching is an alliance building across, as far as across the Middle East, with Russia there. We see that right now over in Sochi, we saw that President Bashar al-Assad from Syria met there with President Vladimir Putin. They had a very warm embrace there together. And of course, the Iranian and also Turkish leaders were meeting in Sochi as well. That's kind of an interesting duo coming together, the Turkish and the Iranians. They have had quite a few conflicts over the years there, but they are putting those differences aside and joining together with Syria and now even possibly with Egypt. We saw today coming out of the Kremlin's website, telephone conversation with President of Egypt, Abdel Fattah el-Sisi. Vladimir Putin had a telephone conversation with him today. In those talks there, they did speak about Syria, how that they had overcome the ISIS militants inside of Syria. And it's kind of made me wonder if Egypt is not wanting to solicit the help of Russian military forces in its own country dealing with ISIS throughout the Sinai Peninsula. That only time will tell exactly whether or not that will be the case. But of course, looking right here at Yorick Isaac and his Twitter page, he put out today showing a military plane from Moscow flying across Turkey and all the way into Egypt today. That's something unusual to see, a military plane actually flying from Russia to Egypt. So you cannot help but wonder if there's not going to be some sort of cooperation between the two countries, very much like that of Russia and Syria there over defeating ISIS in their country there. Clearly seems that Russia is wanting to define its own right in the Middle East there, securing the deals that it has made, including that with Lebanon. And of course, we can't forget about Lebanon, because right now there is a lot of concern between Saudi Arabia, Israel, and the United States over Iran and, of course, Lebanon. Now, the Saudis seem to be more concerned about Lebanon right now than what Israel does. Israel's trying to downplay the situation with Lebanon when it comes to that. But we can't forget about General Wesley Clark and those nations that were to be toppled. And we can't forget about the fact, too, that it was stated by Nikki Haley at the United Nations suggesting that the U.S. would go at it alone against Syria over this chemical weapons, that they had to pay the price, so to speak, there. So we'll have to kind of wait and see how that plays out. Not really sure as of yet. But again, there's the other side as well. Russia is growing on the market there, and resurgent wheat farmers squeezed the U.S. They squeezed them right out of the market there in Egypt. And I'm sure there's probably some would say, well, no big loss after all. But I have to kind of look at the bright side when it comes to Russia. At least Egypt is not getting a GMO product genetically modified from the U.S., because Russia does strictly organic growing. Well, we might say organic growing, but the question might remain, though, whether or not the crops in Russia are going to be organic or are they going to be radioactive? That's another serious issue going on in Russia right now. Russia radioactive record 986 times higher than usual as toxic clouds sparked nuclear accident rumors. And not only is that rumor being brought out by the independent, a UK-based news organization, speaking about a nuclear power plant that is right here in near Mayak, Russia there, as you can see here on the screen right here. And of course, those radioactive particles, which is an isotope that is brought by split atoms, so it has to be from a nuclear power plant, or of course, a nuclear bomb. I don't think I had one go out there. But there's been a higher concentration about 30 kilometers away from Mayak right here, which is close to a nuclear power plant there, and that has made it all the way down to Romania. Nuclear isotopes have been recorded there. And Russia's own independent news or independent agency there that records those types of levels has also confirmed that the 106, which is the one of the isotopes that are there, it is in fact actually present in much higher levels than normal. So that's very troubling, no doubt, for Russia that this is happening. But I'm sure the Russian officials are fully aware that that is going on and not just a suspicion on their part there. Jumping back to an article that I kind of jumped over here for a moment here. Turkey is threatening to move out the U.S.'s radar system that they have inside of Turkey there that helps protect Israel. This is all over the fact of the F-35 deal that is being held up by the United States after Turkey actually had worked an agreement out with Russia to buy the S-400 air defense system there. Now the U.S. is saying that that is a major conflict there in that agreement there, so therefore they may not deliver the F-35s that they had promised Turkey to begin with. And of course there's a lot of rift of whether or not Turkey is going to stay in the NATO alliance. I still believe it's tit for tat and it's just a show of face. I could be wrong. Always got to realize that. I could be wrong. Have no idea on this, but very disturbing to see how this is all going to play out in the end there. But nonetheless, it leaves Israel blinded on a blind side there from Iran missiles coming into the country of Israel if this system is removed. And that might be part of the plan if indeed Turkey is really genuinely working with Russia. Only time will tell about that, especially after the meeting there in Sochi, as we mentioned earlier here in the broadcast. I'm Stephen Benoon. You're watching Israeli News Live. If this type of broadcast is a blessing to you, please consider standing with us and supporting this broadcast, especially our prophetic insights that we bring out. And if you haven't seen it already, this was one of the ones that we did recently, and I really encourage you to check this out. Moses records Syrian prophecy and Israel's modern covenants. Very interesting broadcast there that we did. I know I had a kind of a low view count there, but it is something worth looking at, especially when we're dealing with what we're talking about in the news today. Visit our website, IsraeliNewsLive.org or IsraeliNewsLive.co.il. Either website you can go to there, and you can help support this broadcast by donating online there, as well as on our YouTube channel. If you just simply go to our YouTube page there, right below the subscribe button, you can actually find a place to be able to donate directly on our YouTube channel, which is right there to the far right corner, right there in the picture there. That was actually the suicide bombing that I, by the grace of God, survived. A picture of that I took myself back in 2004 there near the French Hill up near the university there. God miraculously saved my life that day so that I could still be here today to speak with you. I'm Stephen Benoon with Israeli News Live, Erev Tov.